What's up, guys? I'm not customizing my cable, but I'm kind of like doing a little touch up on him because I did that for the first cable. So this cable, the original cable that I have, is from the Juggernaut Wave. So it's this gun is from it. I upgraded that gun and this one. Well, I don't mean upgraded. I mean like I painted the guns. So I think they look kind of cool. So what I did is I used some Tamiya paints, the metallic gray. It's not so glossy like the gunmetal. So I did this a while ago. I think it looks really nice. So what I did is this piece right here, it's like a metallic piece he comes with. I took the two guns he comes with and the metallic piece here. I'm gonna paint them the same color and with the same effects, kind of. And I think he's gonna look pretty cool that way. So far, I have like this right here. That. And right here. It's gone. I paint these red because since cable's from the future, supposedly these are like laser guns. So I just painted red. And I black washed it with the panel line accent color. But then I remembered that there's a better way. If you use an oil wash, so you just take like a black color oil and you mix it with this mineral oil, spirits. You make a black wash, and it's much, much easier to just like put it on and brush it off with a piece of paper. And it's much, much better to do it that way, but I forgot, so I did it the old way. And yeah, I guess this happens when there's all these ways, techniques of doing things, and you kind of forget the little details. So, and then I ran into some trouble. I was like, man, I should have done the other way, the oil way. But it still looks really, I think it looks pretty good. It's the same color as this. So I painted the headpiece, the piece that goes on his face, the same color as the guns. So. And then I dry brushed it. I painted it black first, and then I put the neutral, not the neutral gray, the what is it called? Metallic gray. Yeah, this one. It's a flat color. It's a really good color for metals. And that's what I used for this right here. So, he might come out looking even better. I don't know, I didn't want to take the chance, but I did like the results I got from the first cable, the Juggernaut Wave cable, so I think this might actually look better. I'm gonna do a black wash, oil wash on this right here, and I might put some shading on this right here and here, and I might paint the belt brown and with some metallics for the buckle. And I also put some pledge in here so he won't be so loose this way, because when I've kind of noticed that some of the figures, even out of the box, come with this part right here really loose, and not this way but this way. So I put some pledge so he'll be nice and tight there by tomorrow. And yeah, I think these are coming out really, really nice. And Cable's one of those characters that I didn't know when I was a kid. Because the X-Men from the 80s, the mid 80s, well, the late 80s, were my X-Men, you know. Like the punk rock Storm, and Rogue was also punk rock. So Cable was like sort of kind of like after I stopped reading comics. It was during the Jim Lee era, I guess. So Cable's kind of like a new character to for me, but he has really grown on me. I really like the character. I was actually looking forward to the Deadpool movie seeing Cable because one of the things I like about Cable is that he comes from the future and Sentinels and Nimrod and all that, it's always part of his story. So I was hoping that there would be Sentinels in the Deadpool movie, but they probably didn't have a budget for that. So, but anyway, yeah, this is gonna look pretty cool, I think. So I dry brushed it, like I said. Painted the little tip red right there. Then I'm gonna paint that little dot right there yellow, because I like using yellow and red, sort of kind of like make believe that it's like a futuristic gun, right? So that's one of the things I didn't like about this gun. It came with this like 70s ammo belt, and I was like, come on, like why would they put that with this futuristic gun? So what I did is I customized it, and I put this Magic Sculpt resin piece there, sculpted it, and I think it came out really nice. So I thought maybe I could do the same thing with this Cable, even though I didn't want to touch him because he looks so nice. It's great figures, one of the best figures of the year, I think. Probably is the best figure. I really like Bishop too, so I'll get Bishop probably next month. So yeah, stay tuned. So I'll show the next video, I guess, when almost done or done, I guess. But that's so far what I've done. I modified these three pieces, painted them. I'll put some yellow little lights on it and maybe some more red. Put some red on this guy already. So, and I did the black wash and some dry brush metallic on the black, and they come out really nice. And I think that's all I'm gonna do to him. I was thinking also of painting his hair with a tint of blue. So it'll be white with tint of blue, sort of like the Storm hair. I don't know how I'm gonna do that. I'll probably just do a wash, oil wash, and see how that comes out. So yeah, definitely gonna try that. And also, I'm gonna put some Tamiya yellow clear on this to make this pop out even more, this thing right here. And I was thinking, man, I should paint the head and all that and repaint it and all that, but I was like, man, that's too much trouble. And I might mess up the figure, so I'm just gonna do minor touches on the figure. So, but also I'm gonna do a black wash on these right here, these pads here, so it'll look even nicer. Maybe a little bit of gloss on the red here, like it was in the on the prototype from the videos on YouTube. And yeah, I think that's it. That's what I'm gonna do to the figure. And yeah, look at this gap right here. Look at this. That's where that piece goes. This is sort of like, it looks like it was done in ZBrush, but I saw the sculptor that sculpted this head, and I think he also sculpted this stuff here, I'm sure, but body he didn't sculpt because this is an older body from the Nuke body. So I don't know, but so far what I kind of figured out by myself is that the guy sculpted this by hand. He was using like these bifocals. Pretty funny, like he's like sculpting in the face. So these are so small, you need like really strong magnification. So, but he did a great job, and this looks like it was sculpted in ZBrush because of this panel right here. This not a panel, this hole. It looks like when people model in ZBrush and they want to, make a, sort of like a join or something where two pieces go together. They do a negative and then they put it in there, so it's gonna look really nice when it's finished. I mean, it looks really nice already, but it's gonna look even nicer, I think. So I'll just glue that back in under, and maybe I'll give it a little bit more highlights, just with some silver, because these tester silver metals are really good. So I'll just do a slight that looks pretty good already, man. So yeah, so I'm gonna work on this gun as well. And in this gun, I think it's too short, it's too stumpy. So what I'm gonna do is gonna cut here, make this a little bit longer, about that long, sort of like the Marvel Select one. And then paint it the same color these guns are at, and put some weathering and detail work. And hopefully at the end of it, it'll look really, really, really nice. Really, really nice. So, hope I didn't really mess up the figure, because the figure looks great without any more work done to it, because I'm actually put I'll probably get another one. I like this figure so much, I'll probably get another one. So just kind of had an urge to try and see what I could do. And yeah, so I'm gonna paint his hair a little bit bluish, like a bluish tint, like I said. And yeah, that's it. But I just wanted to share what I'm doing. And boom, 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 that's it. Yeah, that's it, guys. All right, so yeah, I wish he had another hand you could pull out and put in so you could hold both guns. And I think I saw Nuke's hand or some other figure, I don't know, some. Or if you guys know of a good hand that I can use or from another figure, let me know. Because I would love to have two gun holding hands, you know, two gun holding hands, so I can pose them with both guns holding up. The Juggernaut Wave cable can do that. So, and I was thinking, yeah, why don't I just get the gun from the Juggernaut, but I don't want to mess up my Juggernaut cable figure. So I don't know. I'll see how I can get another hand. But if you guys know anything, let me know, because that'll be cool. Yeah, that's it. Nothing else, guys. So, really like this gun. Really nice design. All right, guys. So I'll see you guys later.